this video, we are going to learn how to design different types of oscillator circuits. And we are going to learn how to differentiate different types of oscillator circuits and come to know about the output waveforms of the circuit. So our first oscillator circuit is crystal oscillators. So how we are going to discuss this problem is that first of all, we are going to discuss the circuit of this crystal oscillator, and then we are going to see the output waveforms of the crystal oscillators on multisim. So now let us understand the circuit of this oscillator. So this is the full circuit of crystal oscillator. So let me introduce to each of the component that is used in this circuit. So there are this ground, the resistance, the different resistance are used of different values. This is the op-amp, that is operational amplifiers, which is used to amplify the signals. These two are the Zener diodes. You can see from this circuit, and this component is oscilloscope, in which we are going to see the output waveforms. Now this one is the special component that is used in this oscillator circuit that I am going to explain in the next slide. So how this circuit works? As per this component, the input is given from this this positive end of this op-amp. Now the signal passes through this branch, and this is the capacitor which stores the signal and passes through the oscillator. Now what is the working of this R2? Here the R2 acts as a feedback oscillator, which gives the feedback signal to the negative part of this op-amp. So in this way, the signal oscillates in this way, that it goes on from positive end and goes to the negative as a feedback. So in this way, and the above part is given 16 volt supply, and lower part is also given 16 volt supply. Means when we are going to see the output waveform of this crystal oscillator, the peak that we are going to see on the positive end and the negative end is going to be of 16 volt. And one more thing I want to add is this is the oscillator circuit. So we are going to get signals with varying amplitudes, but the peak of this signal would be of 16 volt and minus 16 volt. Now let me introduce to this component. This is an IC, and which is comprises of these components. So this IC is known as the quartz crystal. You can clearly see this is the crystal, and metallized electrodes are there. So equivalent circuit of this IC is this one, which comprises of resistance, inductor and capacitance, with the capacitance in parallel with these three components. So now let us see the output waveforms of the crystal oscillators on the multisim. So we have reached the multisim, and this is the same circuit that was there in the previous slide. Now we are going to see the output waveforms of this circuit. So let us click on the play button. See, from this output you can see. You can see that signals of different amplitudes are generated with varying frequency, and you can see the peaks of this signal. This is the output waveform of the crystal oscillator. Let us differentiate the scale like this one. So you can get a more clear picture of the output waveforms. See, you can see the signals with the different amplitudes. That is the main function of oscillators, so that we can get signals of varying amplitudes.